Jones Gym here in Brooklyn, New York for a public workout with WBC World Heavyweight Champion Deontay Wilder, who's going to be going up against Artur Szpilka. That's Saturday, January 16th, and it's at the Barclays Center, and it'll be broadcast live on Showtime.
I'm just happy to be here in New York. You know, there's so much rich history in the heavyweight division. A lot of greats that came forward and made their stumble ground here and set history. So, you know, I'm glad for the opportunity to be able to set history here as well too. You know, fighting at the Barclays Center, being here in the media capital of the world. You know, it's exciting times. I'm looking forward to defending my title and being successful. 2016 is going to be a hell of a year for Deontay Wilder. I think the fans are going to be very, very excited, very impressed, and get what they want this year, because I'm not playing around this year. My goal is to be the undisputed heavyweight champ of the world, and whoever has the belt must come through me. I'm looking forward to it. So, no more sitting around, no more waiting. You know, we're on a mission. My whole team is on a mission, you know, to do what we've been set. Everything that's happened, been in the plan to do, it just seemed like everything happens at the right time in my career, in my life. It's just something, I think God just signed down on me, man. This is why I built that. I was meant to do this. Boxing was my calling in life, and I found my purpose in life. You know, a lot of people look for a lifetime to find their calling. They never do, but I found mine, and I'm just looking forward to the whole year of 2016. Sports just make me athletic to be, because I consider myself the most athletic heavyweight champion in the history of in the division today. You know, but just surrounding myself about people, you know, getting that knowledge of different people that God have placed in my life. It helps me. Everybody, Mark Breland, everybody, you know. So it definitely helped me along my career and to be able to be where I am now. So, you know, I'm happy for it. My opponent, Szpilka, you know, I'm excited. I'm happy for Szpilka of getting the opportunity. You know, he wasn't the original opponent for this fight, but so for him to get the call after a lot of other fighters, and him getting the call and say, hey, you know, you want to fight for the heavyweight title of the world. You know, for him, he got to be excited. He got to be overwhelmed. It's like a dream come true for him. Many fighters don't get the opportunity to fight for a world title. They searched many years, but he got the opportunity. I know it's exciting for him. But at the end of the day, you know, he's never faced a fighter like me. So mobile, agile. I got the highest percentage of not only knockouts, but putting punches out. You know, my punching knockout percentage is high. How many times I punch, my accuracy of knockout is the highest in any heavyweight that's doing it. So he's in for a world of hurt, world of pain. 2016, I'm not playing around with no fighters, nobody.
What's the magnitude of this fight? How big is this fight, man?
I mean, due to the fact that the numbers I put out, you know, Bama winning, and it been 16, you know, 16 year, and I'm fighting on the 16th as well, too. It's big for me, you know. Then being in New York, fighting, making history, you know, putting my name with the other fighters that's been here, man. It's a dream come true. You know, I've been looking for a long time to come to New York and display my talent. And then we're fighting at the Barclays Center. The Barclays Center need a face, and I'm looking forward to making that maybe a home away from home. So it starts on the 16th. Alexander Povetkin, what's my thoughts on him being here? I think it's a sight. I think it's good for him to be here because, truth be told, he's supposed to be an opponent for this fight. But they said they wasn't ready. They needed more time. So as he get this more time, I hope he observed me very well. I hope they take notes. They need one of them big, thick, yellow notepads to take every bit of the notes, because I'm not looking past Artur Szpilka, but I'm definitely looking through him. And I'm looking forward to my mandatory. I'm tired of all the valentories. I'm looking for the mandatory. This is what the people want. I want to give the fans what they want. You know, this haven't been the time, because Deontay not scared. Deontay don't run for nobody. Most of the time, these fighters is, you know, it's be them instead of me, but because of my position and what I hold, it makes it seem like it's me. So I'm looking forward to not only Povetkin being there, but anybody else that's in the division being there, knowing that he is next. And I'm looking forward to taking him out as well, too. Change over to Fury, whoever's here. You know, Fury, the same thing applies to Fury. Fury know what the deal is, too. Fury, I think Fury is exciting for boxing. With the talking and the singing and the things, dressing like Batman in press conferences and stuff, that's entertainment, that's exciting. But when you get up in the ring, it's no games, all games aside. I don't play around. I can be entertaining, exciting, I can talk what I want outside of the ring, but when I get in the ring, I transform into somebody else. I really want to hurt you. I really want to take your head off. I really want to dismantle your face. I really want to do that. I don't want to get to the point where you can't support your family, but I want to hurt you real bad because this is a hurting business that we're in, and that's what we're part of. I'm not playing around with nobody. I keep saying it, and I want y'all to get the message later. I'm not playing with no heaven, nobody that's up in the ring with me. I mean business, and that's what it is. So any of them, you better be ready, be prepared. I say I stay in shape, and that's what I do. I don't believe in getting out of shape. I don't believe in gaining pounds and pounds. Then when you have a camp, it's time to get in shape then. That's one of the things that's been more effective for me, that I stay in shape. And the guys just think, just because on the outside, they may see one thing that they can benefit them, or if I get hit with a punch, or I get buzzed, or, oh, he can't do this and that. When you get in the ring, it's a whole totally different thing. And I'm glad that guys have confidence. I don't want nobody. I want my guys to be more in shape than I. So you won't have no kind of excuse. I want you to be healthy. I don't want you to be like a stubborn and say I was dehydrated, because he became the first heavyweight in history to be dehydrated. When I whoop you, I want you to accept that whooping and go on with your life and maybe try to come up and get the rematch. But for now, it's Artur Szpilka. Congratulate him again. In 2016, it's going down real bad.
Because the pin, this is my surname, Polish, you know?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
This is Szpila. This is the pin.
Uh-huh.
Actually, like Artur and Artie.
Yeah.
We're at Gleason's Gym here in Brooklyn, New York for a public workout with WBC World Heavyweight Champion Deontay Wilder, who's going to be going up against Artur Szpilka. That's Saturday, January 16th, and it's at the Barclays Center, and it'll be broadcast live on Showtime. What's your biggest challenge in this fight?
What, for me?
Yes, for you.
Very important, you know, I can change story. I told before, I can change story, I can be a first heavyweight champion of the world. Polish people have warriors, you know. We was Adamek, Gołota, you know, every fighter. Now Głowacki, cruiserweight champion, he knocked him out to Cook. We have so much fighters, you know, Andy Fonfara, you know. But we never was heavyweight champion, and I know I can be him, and I will be.
You're going to be the champ.
Exactly. This is for me, no only fight about... Exactly, listen, this is no fight only about belt. This is fight about change story, you know, this is for me. Oh my God, hey, listen, sometimes when somebody is world champion, you know, for example, and die, nobody remember him. But first heavyweight champion of the world, Polish people, everybody will be remember.
The story sort of changed too with Klitschko out of the picture. Your thoughts on that with Klitschko?
What?
Klitschko is no longer the champion. It's sort of changed.
Your
thoughts?
This is boxing. I'm happy because Fury now is champion. He changed his... I know he's something like, you know, interesting. Klitschko was, you know, I don't like watch Klitschko, you know, he not was like, he was champion, respect, he was good guy, but he not have like emotion, you know, and I'm happy because now new generation coming, you know, and this is good.
Thank you.
We're here at Gleason's Gym in Brooklyn, New York for a public workout. It's for the vacant IBF Heavyweight World Championship. We have Charles Martin going up against Czar Glazkov.
To win, you know, you know, getting there is never good enough. That's like whatever, you know. You gotta break the barrier and get over to the other side, you know, and that's what we're gonna do Saturday.
How was your amateur record? Was that a prerequisite that you have enough fights to make it easy to come into the pros?
Yeah, I had 63 amateur fights. You know, I won a national title. You know, in the 2012 national PAL, and you know, I was the runner up. I was a runner up in the Golden Gloves that year, and I beat the guy that I got a draw with. I mean, not a draw, but a lost the decision to in the PAL. So, you know, that's how close it was. It wasn't, you know, hey, it's all good. It's the amateurs. We just learning. We just getting the experience for this game right here.
It's revenge time.
Yeah, revenge.
So what is your prediction for Saturday?
Like I said, I'm not the one to, you know, predict boxing, but I'm gonna go out there on my A game. So, you know, that's what it's gonna be.
Just one last question. Is this your first time in New York?
No, I fought at the Madison Square Garden. I fought at the B.B. King little nightclub. Yeah. So this is like my third time fighting in New York.
So it's a comfort station. It's not coming to a new place.
No, not at all. It's good. It's a good place to fight at. I like being here. I enjoy it.
God bless me.
Thank you.
Have you watched any of Czar Glazkov fights in the past?
Yeah, I watched the Malik Scott fight. And I watched the Derek Rossi fight.
So you didn't get a chance to check out the Steve Cunningham fight?
No, because I already pulled it off the internet.
So what do you want to tell the fans that haven't seen you fight before? You're going to be fighting on Showtime Championship Boxing. I'm sure this must be a big experience for you.
They'll get to see the all the things that I've been working on in the gym, you know, all the things that they didn't know I had, like hand speed, that middleweight hand speed, you know, that good movement, you know, being elusive, getting out the way of punches, you know, slipping if I need to slip. You know, they gonna see everything. I'm a full total package. You know, I'm a total fighter, complete fighter.
Are you going for the knockout, or is that something you're going for, or you're gonna try to outbox him?
No, I don't go for the knockouts. They just come. You know, we let them come to us. You know, we put them in position to get knocked out. You feel me?
We're here at Gleason's Gym in Brooklyn, New York for a public workout. It's for the vacant IBF Heavyweight World Championship. We have Charles Martin going up against Czar Glazkov.
Another champion in my stable.
Yeah, how's that going to happen?
I'm confident.
How's it going to happen? Is it basically...
Well, we all know Czar is not a big puncher. So I'm not saying it's going to be knockout, but as far as the talent, Czar is two hits ahead of Charles Martin. So I think my prediction would be a 12-round decision.
Martin, on paper, maybe not the toughest guy he's been in with, on paper, would you say?
Did you see video?
Yeah.
So what's that video? Tell me about video different from a paper. He's a slow. He can hit, but probably my grandmama can see a punch coming from here. And in a slow motion.
This guy is fast. Is what?
Fast. He has the speed hands. He has the talent. So talent against the puncher. Everything can happen in boxing. Me and you would know about it. Lucky punch can be happen. I saw guys winning 10 rounds and getting knocked out in the end of a round. You saw that. So everything is happening, it's boxing. I'm not predicting anything. I'm not in the ring. I'm gonna be watching a fight as you are. That's his job, what he's gonna do, and how he wants to see his career in the later round. That's
all
it.
All we can do before is sort of guesstimate and see what might happen. You're very confident, though, about this fight going in?
Listen, if I wouldn't be confident, I wouldn't be telling him to fight. I'm confident. How it's going to go, I can't say. I am not fighting. So I am not the guy who's going to say, my guy is coming in the ring to kill every guy. So we're going to see. Saturday night, we're going to show.
So
But I am confident of my fighter. I'm confident he's going to win. I'm confident he's going to be another champion in my stable.
Вы, конечно, видео просмотрели. Чуть-чуть выше меня левша, ну что, готовили специально под него, поэтому
yes,
все хорошо.
Yes, I did see his video. He's a taller guy than I am. He's a southpaw. I was preparing especially for him.
The fact that he's a southpaw, you say, especially preparing that he sparred with southpaws to get ready for the another southpaw.
Да, конечно, были левши, высокие левши, поэтому со спарринг партнерами проблем не было. Хорошая подготовка прошла.
I had no problem with my sparring partners. All of my sparring partners was taller than me, and everybody was a southpaw.
Can you tell us who he
sparred with? No big name, absolutely no.
Oh
yeah, he sparred a guy, Chinese guy, where he fought in Olympics.
Yes. Yes.
A lefty.
We're at the Barclays Center in Brooklyn, New York, where Deontay Wilder defeated Artur Szpilka by ninth round knockout to retain the WBC heavyweight title. And in the co-main event, Charles Martin defeats Czar Glazkov to take the IBF heavyweight title. And now, let's go to post.
But I expected him to win the heavyweight title. I've had piece of a heavyweight champion before, Sultan Ibragimov, and there's nothing better than being involved with the heavyweights, because that usually drives the train. And it did for many years in the U.S. with Ali and Frazier and all the great American heavyweights. Well, they're back. You got two of the four belts down here. And this guy's the real deal. He's better than all of them. And he's going to beat all of them at some point.
Thank you. Charles, do you see this as a mixed blessing? Obviously, it's a big victory being the heavyweight champion of the world, one of the heavyweight title holders. But at the same time, this was a grand spotlight being on this card, and you didn't necessarily get a chance to show what you think you're capable of because of what happened with Glazkov.
Yeah, definitely. I got a lot to show. You know, I just wanted to display what we've been working on for so long, you know. Unfortunately, it ended the way it did. But, you know, I'll be back soon.
Scott Schaefer. He's got a mic.
Question for Charles, and maybe his management might want to answer this, but congratulations. If you were in control of your own destiny, what would be next for you?
Unify all the belts. I want to fight Tyson Fury. I want to fight Deontay Wilder. I want everything. I want all the hardware. Starting with this IBF right here.
Any particular order?
Well, Tyson Fury has more belts, so we'll take that first then.
Tyson's busy with Klitschko, obviously, so I think people would want to see the first step, which would naturally be Charles and Deontay. I think that's a fight that a lot of people would want to see. You know,
as long as the fans want it, I'm with it. Yep.
Two big, strong American heavyweights that can punch like that. Lights out, you know? And he's a better one.
Congratulations, Charles.
Thank you.
What was your reaction to the crowd's negative reaction after you seemed to take responsibility for him tearing his ACL and you had about 10,000 people booing you?
Oh, I didn't
hear that.
Yeah, I knew I didn't do like hit him. I knew I didn't. You know, something happened. You know, he tore his ACL. But, you know, he didn't have a punch. You know, he was going to my body and stuff like that. You know, he just didn't have enough power, you know. So I was going to catch up with him eventually. You know, I'm patient. I'm a patient fighter. You can watch in all my previous fights, you know. I'm very patient. And I did not take credit for that ACL tear, no. I knew I didn't hit him. That's why I was confused. I'm like, what just happened? I didn't even know what happened when it happened, but, you know.
We're at the Barclays Center in Brooklyn, New York, where Deontay Wilder defeated Artur Szpilka by ninth round knockout to retain the WBC heavyweight title.
First off, I'd like to say, man, I'd like to thank Brooklyn for the love and support. I'd like to thank the Polish people for the love and support of this over 115 years of we're in the street here, man. It was a wonderful crowd. It was a beautiful atmosphere. And definitely my prayers goes out to Szpilka tonight. I just want to thank him for accepting the opportunity that we gave him and did a job well done. You know, I'm definitely looking forward to coming here again and putting my title on the line once more. You know, the atmosphere again was beautiful, man. And man, I can't wait. The heavyweight division is very exciting. It done got exciting again, and a lot of things is going on. So again, I'd like to thank you guys again. Any questions?
I don't want to take away from the victory, but, you know, Povetkin was here ringside. That's your mandated fight next. How do you think that fight's going to go, and how confident do you feel ahead of the biggest fight of your life?
I'm super confident in that fight. You know, I've been waiting for Povetkin for a very long time. And I'm looking forward to him as well, too. I got a lot of valedictories out the way. I'm looking for my mandatory as well, too. You know, I'm glad that he was here to take notes and stuff like that. We all know style make fights, and I'm looking forward to it. I'm very confident with him or anybody that I'm going to get in the ring with. My goal is to be the undisputed heavyweight champion of the world, man, and that's my mission.
If Povetkin was taking notes, what should he make note of more than anything else? What should be his takeaway?
He should make note of my long with Povetkin. It's going to be, you know, he should take notes of everything. Just don't take nothing for granted. You know, like I said before, different fighters bring different talent out of people. With Szpilka, he was more mobile. He was more slicker. I haven't faced a southpaw in like 3 years, so it took me a little bit more time to adjust than I thought I would. And so he said, you know, when you're watching a fight, you can never just never tell. So he just should take note of everything, not from just this fight, from the previous fight, the jab, right hand, hook. You know, truth be told, my right hand was like, once I fought for the title with Berman Severn, I broke my hand, and it's been like a year that my hand been sore. But now it's back. It's 100%, and I'm still a dangerous fighter. We always say we don't know when it's going to happen, but when it's going to happen, that's mean when I crack you on the right with that right hand, you know, things going to happen.
Thank you.
Deontay, how close did you feel the fight was when you knocked him out?
I knew I was winning. I knew I was up. I definitely thought it was close. You know, it wasn't that much action going on. So I knew it was pretty close. But you know, that didn't bother me. I just knew we had 12 rounds to go, and I'm in great shape. You know, so whatever, if it would have went the distance, I wouldn't have no worries. You know, so but again, I'm a dangerous fighter, and what have made me gain my name is knocking people out. That's what I do, you know. So any fighter feel that I'm not danger or to their career or to their record, you know, they're lying to themselves. That's one of my attributes about myself. My right hand is a monster. Sometimes I get scared of it myself. And true story. And it's unbelievable what, especially when I hit you at the right time at the right moment. Is when I hit him, I knew it was over. I knew immediately when I felt it, and I hit him, I knew it was over with them.
What did you think Povetkin thought when he saw that?
Oh shit.
Deontay, congratulations on your third straight title defense. You and I talked about we thought Szpilka was gonna come out, be aggressive. It was his home crowd. You looked off for, I'd say, the first three or four rounds. What was it, the crowd? Was it Spilka's style? What was it about you that you looked just not yourself?
It was just his style, man. He had I got an awkward style, but his style was just crazy awkward. You know, it was almost like, you know, I had to do the chasing, then he coming forward. It was just kind of a weird feeling. Just then getting back to the sense of fighting the southpaw and stuff like that, just the movement. And, you know, the crowd didn't bother me. I really don't listen to the crowd. Only people I hear is my corner. You know, no matter how many people's in there, I enjoy the crowd to want to have fun and stuff like that. It was just he just had an awkward style.
One last question.
First of all, congratulations, Jonathan, on a fantastic
Thank
performance.
I like your hat.
Robert Brazil, Real Combat Media. Thank you. I like yours, too. You've spoken about unifying the title, and as you know, unlike years past, we have an alphabet city. Now, Fury may win the rematch, but Klitschko could also win the rematch also. You also saw Charles Martin win a piece of the IBF title tonight, and Ruslan Chagov has a piece of the WBA title, the lesser one. Would you be open to fighting these other names if they're presented to you?
Oh, most definitely. Most definitely. You know, whoever has to be, like I said, my goal is to be the undisputed heavyweight champion of the world. So whoever had the rest of the belts, that's who I want. You know, I want to, like I said, boxing is getting exciting again for the heavyweight division. Why not keep it going? You know, people want to see the great fights. Let's make them happen. You know, I got a great team behind me, and I think they feel the same way as I feel, you know. And so with that being said, whoever has them, that's who I want. You know, of course, in the heavyweight division is fewer fighters. So, of course, I can't fight the best all the time, you know, because of this thing is not like the welterweight or the middleweight or the junior middleweight where you have so many guys in there, so many great guys. It's a small division. But whoever has the titles, that's who I want. Thank you guys so much.
Kristal Hart reporting from the Barclays Center here in Brooklyn, New York. Hope you've enjoyed the show. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you at the fights.